actually this program was the one of the very first programs I have been briefed about from Shank when I joined the program and from the our team here. I was very happy to learn about the program, and I met with Adam actually before I even joined the academy. He was the MC of one of the training and learning events in London. And one of the very few things he shared with me in just 10 minutes conversation was this program. So I really looked into the program, the activities you have done, the internship you have finished. It gives me a really great pleasure that we really launched such a program and we have invested in this group of really young talents. Without further ado, I would like to again to congratulate you and wish you all the best. And this is not the end of it. This is the only the beginning of the journey. And we extend our arm, we extend our facilities, our programs to serve you and your organizations that you are working for right now. Now we are discussing with Saad, with the Al-Ahli Bank, a big, huge initiative. We are, inshallah, realizing this initiative shortly, and with the other also banks, QFBA and Commercial Bank and the other subsidiaries. We are very welcomed and we are very eager to really work with everybody in the industry. Without further ado, I would like to give the floor to Shank, our CEO. Actually, he was one of the supporters, not for the only for the program, but one of the supporters and founders of the whole QFBA, the Qatar Finance and Business Academy. Thank you for accepting to give the speech for our graduates today, and the floor is yours.
Thank you, Dr. Aziz. Let me add my congratulations to the graduating batch. Mabruk, well done. And like Dr. said, it's learning is always a start of the journey. Never point ends. I'm sure all of you, plus myself, I feel that I learn every day. And if I stop learning, I feel that I'm stagnating, which is not good. So I congratulate you. I wish you well for your onwards journey. These are definitely very exciting times that we are all living in. The interesting thing is that yes, we have this huge, big financial crisis going on, but for me, it's an encouraging moment because I have great faith in human innovation and great faith in human ability to find its way out. And these kind of moments always lead to new ideas and the birth of new thoughts that come from such moments. So I think it's an exciting time, and to be here at this moment, to be in the organization that you are, to grasp that moment, especially sitting here in Qatar, where we are blessed with a good economy, we are blessed with good opportunities. So this is a wonderful moment to grasp that and to take a leap from that. I think the world itself looks and is looking upon the Middle East to play that role, not just in terms of providing capital, but also thought leadership. Coming up with new ways of doing things, new ideas of doing things. Islamic finance is a great example of that, new inventions coming to the fore. So these are, in my mind, very exciting times. These are obviously trepidatious times as well, but if one is careful and smart about it, I think whether it was the Great Depression or the 80s problems, financial problems, all of them have resulted in great booms after that. And I believe that this is such a moment for us to be here. I always find it a little bit difficult in moments such as these in terms of what to say to a graduating batch. Apart from wish them luck, but I think When I first came to Qatar 7 years ago, and I remember the QFC had just literally just started off. We were about maybe 10, 15 people, including the office drivers. And we were still in the Ministry of Economy and Commerce, it used to be called back then, now the MBT. We were in that building on the 14th floor. And I think it was in my second or third week that I had landed here, that I was in a meeting with Her Highness, Sheikh Hamouza at Qatar Foundation. And I was talking about the idea of setting up the QFBA. And it must have taken her maybe 15 seconds to be to the idea and to give her support for that. So from that moment to this moment, when I see where, you know, such growth and progress has happened, we have graduating batches. It's a tremendous journey for all of us here. And it wouldn't be successful without your participation in it. And particularly for the local Qatari community, which is so important for financial services industry in particular, in my opinion. Because in Qatar, if you take a step back and look at it, it's about, we have the oil and gas industry, which generates a lot of capital, generates a lot of income and wealth. And so we need to manage that very well. And then we need to manage the money that is generated. So those, in my opinion, are the two most important functions in Qatar. And those need to be in local hands. And we have to control that and be right at the forefront of that. So that's been the thought behind QFBA as well, is to really embed the passion for financial services into the local community. And so I believe we are making really great progress in that direction. Our support continues from the QFC Authority. An interesting thing is also not only just from the QFBA perspective, but also from the QFCA's perspective as well. Almost 60% of our firms that are in the pipeline are now local Qatari firms, which are using the QFC model.